Turp and Runt. Story by Lisa Wheeler. Pictures by Frank Ansley. Turk's parents were so proud of him. He was the biggest, strongest, and the most graceful bird on Wishbone Farm. "He's a dancer," said his mother. "He's an athlete," said his father. "He's a goner," said his brother Runt. But no one ever listened to Runt. Every year, farm animals looked forward to the excitement of autumn. Carloads of people came to pick red ripe apples from the orchard in September. Folks arrived to choose plump orange pumpkins from the field in October. Come November, it was turkey time. One by one, fattest, roundest turkeys were chosen. "Chosen for what?" asked Turk. "To be the lead dancer in Swan Lake," said his mother. "Play the Thanksgiving Day football game," said his father.
"To be roasted and gently basted," said his brother Runt.
But no one ever listened to Runt. So every morning in November, the family watched Turk practice his dance steps. 1, 2, 3, lift. And every afternoon, the family watched Turk practice his football moves. 16, 23, 47. "Hike!" "He's getting stronger," said his mother. "He's getting bigger," said his father. "He's getting juicier," said his brother Runt. But no one ever listened to Runt. 2 days before Thanksgiving, Madam Waddle, famous ballet instructor, arrived at Wishbone Farm. She came to choose a turkey. "An audition," Mother squealed.
"It's your time to shine.
Go out there and shake those tail feathers." Turk gracefully danced to the front of the barnyard. He leaped, he spun, he twirled and whirled. He did his triple somersault and landed in a split.
"Look at the size of those zumpsticks," said Madam Waddle. "That is a beautiful bird."
Mother beamed. Father puffed out his tail feathers. Pride. Runt puffed out his tail feathers through. Then he threw himself on the ground. He flapped. He flopped. He hissed and sputtered. He gobbled like a maniac as he chased Madam Waddle out of the barnyard.
"Skibloo!" screamed Madam Waddle. "These birds are crazy!"
Then she drove far, far away from Wishbone Farm.
"No Swan Lake," cried Mother. "No steering roll," cried Father.
"No roasted turkey with chestnut dressing," cried Runt. Hooray! But no one ever listened to Runt.
The day before Thanksgiving, Coach Giblet of the Crow City Cornshuckers came to pick out a turkey.
"This is your big chance," said Father. "Get out there and strut your stuff."
Turk sprinted to the front of the barnyard. He bobbed. He weaved. He tackled and dived. He mowed down every turkey who got in his way.
"That's one healthy looking bird," said Coach Giblet. "All the biggest and best for my team."
Father grinned proudly. Mother got tears in her eyes.
Runt got tears in his eyes too. Then his beak began to drip. He coughed, he wheezed, he sniffled and sneezed. He fell onto the ground in a hacking fit of quivering feathers.
"Good gravy!" shouted the coach as he hopped back into the team bus. "These birds are very sick birds. The cornshuckers deserve better." And he sped off far, 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 far away from Wishbourne Farm.
"No football contract!" cried Father. "No TV commercials!" cried Mother. "No turk sandwich with cranberry sauce!" cried Runt. "Hooray!" But no one ever listened to Runt. It was Thanksgiving morning. Turk's family heard the put, 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 put of a little old car. Out the car climbed a little old lady.
"Maybe she's a little old talent-stop," said Father.
"Maybe she's a little old dance instructor," said Mother.
"I hope she's a little old vegetarian," said Runt.
Father and Mother pushed Turk to the front of the barnyard.
"Show her what you've got!"
But before Turk could perform even one peroot, the little old lady scooted him aside.
"Aha!" she exclaimed, pointing at Runt. "Exactly what I've been looking for. This is a bird the just size for me."
"What?" cried Mother.
"Him!"
cried Father.
"Help!" cried Runt.
No one ever listened to Runt. He ran behind Father.
"Don't let her eat me."
He ran behind Mother.
"Hide me, hide me."
He ran behind Turk.
"I'm young. I'm too young to be bested."
Turk saw the look in the little old lady's eyes. He saw the drool on her lips. He saw the fork in the little old lady's pocket. He saw the roasting pan in her backseat. Runt had been right all along. "Work with me, Runt," Turk instructed, "or your goose is cooked." Turk bobbed and weaved. Runt flapped and drooled. Turk leaped and twirled. Runt coughed and wheezed.
"Stuff and nonsense!"
Runt gobbled like a maniac. While Turk dived down and tackled the little old lady's shoes.
"Stuff and nonsense!" cried the little old lady, climbing back to her car. "I wouldn't eat these birds if they were the last turkeys on earth."
That day, as the family feasted on corn and alfalfa, they had much to be thankful for. "I'm thankful for we're all together," said Mother. "I'm thankful for two brave sons," said Father. "I'm thankful for such a smart brother," said Turk. "We're not out of the woods yet," Runt warned. "Come December, folks begin planning their holiday dinners." "Dinners that include stuffing?" asked Mother. "Dinners that include gravy?" asked Father. "Dinners that include me?" asked Turk. "Over my feathered body," Runt said. "We're not plucked yet. I have a grade A plan." At this time, everyone listened to Runt. The end.